Hi everyone! I know you're probably wondering, wow Eva, why are we zoomed into your face so much? And why are you not wearing any makeup? And why are you hardly woken up? Still got dark circles under my eyes and all that? Well, today I thought we'd do a review of the Naked Skin One and Done Hybrid Complexion Perfector. I am always searching for a foundation that I can wear on a day-to-day basis. Something that's not too heavy, because I actually don't like wearing makeup. Like, I know what you're thinking, you're like, bitch, you need it. But I'm comfortable without makeup. Obviously not all the time, but there are days that I wake up and I'm like, you're alright. Today is not one of them days, but you know, not everyone's perfect and we all have them days. But yeah, I'm always looking for like a foundation that doesn't feel heavy on your skin, because I've got a combination skin, so I'll get a very oily T-zone and then everywhere else is pretty much dry. So it's very frustrating, and I've had loads of different foundations and they all seem to sort of like just become cakey around here just by the end of the day and just feel greasy everywhere else, even though they look good. So when I heard that this was coming out, I was so excited because I love Urban Decay, partly because they're just such an interesting brand. Like, I love that they come out with sort of quite unique sort of products and stuff, and then also they are cruelty free, and then I think they do vegan makeup as well. So when this came out, I was like, this gal over here needs to try this out. I've had one of their foundations before, so I've had the Naked Skin foundation, and even though I loved how it felt on my skin, it did become cakey at the end of the day. So let me just give you a little sort of background on what this little thing is. So it's instantly blurs perfection and evens out skin tone for beautifully perfected ultra definition skin. Our high-tech weightless formula provides all day wear and feels amazing, but the best part is how it transforms the look of your skin. Light diffusing spheres instantly help make flaws seem to disappear. Over time, pores look smaller and skin appears noticeably firmer and more radiant. So it claims that it lasts up to 8 hours. The shade that I've got in this is light, which I have tried this product out, but haven't actually like recorded my whole actual process. So even though I know what it feels and stuff like that on my skin, I actually want to talk through it and actually really think about it and do sort of a review throughout the day, how it feels like on hour 4, hour 3 and all that kind of stuff. I'm gonna try this out, I'm gonna apply it, I'm going to see how it wears out throughout the day, how it feels, and I'm gonna record it all and let you guys know. So maybe you want to try it out, or you've been interested in this project or anything like that. Maybe you're looking for like a light sort of foundation that's not very heavy on your skin, and whether this is the right one. Like, the packaging's like this, so it looks like a tube, but it does have the pump bit here, so that's quite good, obviously. I do love a good pump. It recommends to use a like optical blurring brush or something like that from Urban Decay to apply this. I unfortunately don't have it, and I apply most of my foundation with a Real Techniques sponge. Let's see how it works. So I'm just gonna put it on side of my hand. It looks like it's darker than my skin tone because I am a pasty pale white girl, but when I actually use it on my skin, as you'll see in a moment, it does blend out quite nicely. I would also like to mention that I do have a couple of little breakouts, like this one, but this one's actually going down. You know, it's so tiny. Well, like, I know it's visible, but it's not juicy or anything like that, so I'm not really bothered about covering that up. So yeah, gotta deal with that. Instantly, as I'm applying it, it doesn't feel like I'm wearing foundation. Like, it doesn't feel heavy or anything like that. With a lot of foundations, like, you can really tell, like, you know, that you're painting your face literally when you apply foundation, but not with this one. This one's like nice. It feels kind of like a, don't know, like a moisturizer but also a primer at the same time. Just blended down my neck just a little bit. Okay, so I hope you can tell my skin just looks a bit more brighter and just even sort of tone. It doesn't look cakey. It looks cool. Like, it just looks like what I want my skin to basically look like, you know, just slightly less gray and slightly less pale and slightly less spotty. And so what I'm gonna do now is that I'm meeting with a friend later on, going out for lunch. So when I come back, I'm gonna update you and show you what it looks like and how it feels. feels and whether I felt any differences or anything like that. Let me just bring the camera a little bit closer, show you what it looks like really close. I mean, I thought we can get closer than this, but... So I'm back. So it's been about it's been almost 5 hours since I've applied the foundation. So I've been out, I've gone out shopping, I've gone out for lunch with friends. So let's have a quick look. I mean, I have had a look in the mirror already, but not kind of like under this light. This is a good light to see everything that you also want to see, but also don't want to see. So I mean, today's a pretty hot day in England. By hot, I mean it's about 20 degrees, and for those who live in the UK know this is like, what's going on? This is our heat wave. The thing with it, England is very humid, so it's actually interesting to see how this has sort of withstanded that with me having also combination skin. I think it's done pretty well. Like, it looks pretty much the same as it has done when I first applied it. I didn't feel like it was heavy throughout the day or anything like that. So far anyway, it's felt pretty like I don't have anything on, but I still I mean, I can kind of see where I've worn my sunglasses a bit. I think it's come off just here. Yeah, like it hasn't actually, like normal foundation does, it hasn't gone weird around this, just like, you know, the nostril area or whatever. It stayed pretty much the same, which is very impressive. Like, I can feel, like, if I touch my nose like that, I can feel it getting a little bit oily. So it's gonna be interesting how it goes on for the next sort of 4 hours or whatever, whether that's going to be an issue. But it's not coming off. And it looks great, and it feels weightless. It feels like I'm not wearing it. So far, really impressed. So yeah, let's see how the next 4 hours carry on. Oh yeah, and I did ask the friend that I went out for lunch with, I did ask her whether she thought I was wearing foundation, and she said that she didn't think I was wearing foundation. I was like, psych, got you. I am. I'm wearing the Naked Skin One and Done. So that was pretty cool. I was like, wow, I actually am. This unfortunately isn't my natural skin. Although it's close to it, you know, don't get me wrong. I do have all right skin, but it's just not as even toned and like this, unfortunately. See you guys in the next 4 hours. Bye. Has been eight, I don't know why I'm doing this, I'm just like hyperactive right now. It has been 8 hours since I have applied my face, and it has not melted off yet, which is very pleasing to know, because I haven't used a primer, I haven't used a setting spray or anything like that. So what you see right now is how my face has been. It has gone through two meals, and trust me, gal, sometimes food can get messy. It's not all over my face, so I've done well on that front. For the entire day, it hasn't felt like I've been wearing foundation. So yeah, as you can see, it has gotten a little bit oily around my nose, but that's to be expected because it has been warm and humid today. Like, I can feel my forehead, probably sounds gross, but it has gotten a little bit sticky. But yeah, my skin feels like it's sort of breathed throughout the day, even though it has been warm. Let me just bring the camera up a little bit closer again and see the beauty that I am. Can you see my nose? Can you see my nose? It hasn't shelled. That's what I like about it, that it hasn't become weird and bitty around my nose, which it normally does. I am really pleased with this product. If you guys are looking for something like a weightless, kind of like almost like a tinted moisturizer, I really recommend trying this out for the summer, because it seems like the perfect sort of opportunity to try a foundation like this out. And yeah, I wouldn't wear it on like obviously a night out, but on a day-to-day basis, or for just like a casual meetup with friends, if you still wanna look a little bit fresher and stuff, I would really recommend this. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this review. Thank you so much for watching. If you have enjoyed that, please leave me a comment or like this video, share, subscribe. I would really, really appreciate it. And I shall see you soon. Bye, everyone. Stop texting me, everyone. Wow. I am the prettiest girl in this planet. I'm just finishing a video, so would you guys mind being quiet just for a second? Love Island's at 9.
Sorry, what is?
Love Island's at 9.
Yes, it's already 9:10.
Wow. Just give me literally 5 minutes, okay? Just 5.
2 minutes.
5.
Olga, we got any spare toilet roll? I'm only joking, I just wanted to put that one.